Well, my name is Daniel Bell, and I'm from Montreal, Canada. And I've been teaching and working as a political theorist here in China for 24 years.
There's a rhythm and rush these days, where the lights don't move and the colors don't fade.
There's good and bad memories. The worst experience probably is when I was told that my mother, who's 84 years old from Montreal, contracted COVID, but luckily or miraculously, even though she had many predisposing conditions, she didn't have any symptoms, and she tested positive 3 times and I was back to normal. So that scare was over. To be frankly speaking, it feels quite lucky to be here, especially since the month of March or so, when much of the rest of the world, including my hometown Montreal, which actually has more COVID cases than Wuhan, believe it or not. The most memorable time experienced during that time was when we realized that we wouldn't be traveling around the world. We happened to walk by a pet store in Shanghai, and we immediately fell in love with a baby kitten, and we adopted that kitten, and we've been raising him since. And that's, I think, is probably the best experience we've had in 2020. And here in China, we had experience with SARS in 2003, which mobilized people, and people could remember. I mean, actually, I was in Hong Kong in 2003, and as soon as I heard about these cases, or some sort of strange new disease, which sounded like a bit like SARS, immediately, you know, we went out to buy masks and so on. I think if countries didn't have recent experience with epidemics that are similar to COVID, it also explains a slower reaction. It's not necessarily easy to transit for the China case, both for cultural, political, and historical reasons, for other countries to learn from China. Well, I wish they did, but it's not likely. So why is that? I mean, there has to be a tradition of trust, of expertise, both scientific expertise and also trust in the government, that they're ultimately going to use the science for the purpose of benefiting the people. So countries that lack those elements, or we can say those traditions, might not do as well. I mean, in the US, people blame the president, whose policies often seem to be not only not informed by science, but actively skeptical, if not hostile to science.
You literally cannot mandate somebody to wear a mask knowing that that mask is killing people. And you, doctor, are going to be arrested for crimes against humanity.
But the problem is that the people are the problem sometimes. If the people lack trust in scientific expertise and lack trust in political rulers that are supposed to implement policies for their benefit.
I got every problem with the government saying we can't go out. That's a prohibition. Freedom! Freedom!
My current freedom matters more than my desire to protect my own life and protect the life of other people. No matter what kind of government you have, it's not going to work very well. And also, frankly speaking, much of the science that helps to prevent COVID can also has a downside, that it could constrain our privacy in ways that people might find objectionable. But in countries that strongly value privacy, they might not be willing to accept those technologies. So this kind of libertarian, very strong libertarian strand, let's call it libertarianism, populism, some sort of very anti-elite tradition, it's quite widespread in the US, but not at all widespread in China. And the big example in China is Dr. Zhong Nanshan, who, when he sounded the alarm on COVID in late January, immediately the people mobilized and understood that this is a serious problem and agreed to follow the measures. So there has to be this kind of dual faith. One is faith in Junzi, or to use modern language, kind of experts that have both ability and virtue, meaning that they use those abilities for morally desirable purposes, and faith in public officials that also have the ability and motivation to implement policies that are benefit the public. So countries that lack those traditions find it much harder.
What is political theory? We have to look at ordinary people, look at citizens.
In our new book, Just Hierarchy, we argue what would justify a hierarchy between rulers and the ruled. and the two main political traditions in China. One is Confucianism, and Confucianism is a very diverse tradition, but basically all Confucians agree that the main purpose of government is to serve the people, and that there has to be a strong element of trust between the rulers and the ruled. Another tradition is the legalist tradition, which basically justifies very harsh measures when it comes to national emergencies and threats to social order, like warfare or pandemics. And arguably, you had both the legalist tradition and the Confucian tradition, which merged and helped to explain the relative success of dealing with COVID.